So here we are in the month of November. It's getting cold outside, and what's that mean? That means that mice are moving inside. This is a deer mouse. The trap that it's in is an A24. That's really for rats. The mice don't tend to trigger it very often, although they do. But for the purposes of this video, I'm going to show you how to catch them alive with that live catch trap right there. It's called the CaptSure trap, and it comes in two sizes. Look at that mouse just hanging out in the entrance, not going in. But in this video, I'm going to show you how to set it up. So they go in, and you're going to trap them. Look here, in my basement. Nothing worse than to see a surveillance camera come on and catch a deer mouse running along the side of the concrete blocks there. And they've even been going in and out of holes. They chewed through the mortar. So I need to catch this mouse too. It's the same mouse. Two different time cycles here, and I'm going to show you how I do it. I'm going to show you how to set up the trap, what my method is, and tell you a little bit about these deer mice. There are two types of mice that end up in our house around this time of year. That would be the house mouse and the deer mouse. You're going to get to see them up close. Why? Because I'm going to trap them. Some people are averse to trapping and killing rodents. So those people will be very happy to know that in this video, we're going to catch them alive and unharmed. So here we go. This is the one that's out in the bee shed there. And it's going to walk right into my trap. The A24 is on the right. Remember, that's primarily for rats, although it will catch mice. But today we're doing the CaptSure live trap. All plastic. Spring-loaded. Watch this. Remember that these mice only weigh about a half ounce to an ounce, so you need a sensitive trigger. But look what happens. See the tail? The door trips shut, but the tail is caught. Let's watch it in slow motion. So though it caught the tail, didn't injure it really, there are two options for this trap. There's a large version and a small version. I'm going to show them both to you. Here's that mouse right on the kitchen table, probably where most wild mice should not be. But my wife wasn't home, so I decided this is where I would make my video. And you can see that the mouse does look a little bit stressed, but these traps don't hurt them. And I'm going to go over how to set this up, complete with this little bait station on the end. There's plenty of ventilation in these so that the mice don't suffocate. But as with any live catch trap, you want to make sure and check in on them. I have an advantage because I do use the Arlo 2 motion-activated cameras that you can check with your phone, your computer, anything else, and see if anything's gone into your trap. Plus, it lets you know when motion is detected. So this little dude is not happy. But look, here's the large version. I'm going to go over the details of it. They function exactly the same. And they are available on Amazon. I paid full price for them. I don't have any affiliation whatsoever with the capture company. And my mouse is still in there. Don't worry, I'm going to let that one out. But we're going to catch two more, and I'm going to use this large trap. Notice the holes that are here? That's on the side with the trigger plate. The other side is the bait, and I'm sure that you want to know what the physical dimensions are of these traps. This is the bait side, and they have this sticky because they want to make sure that people understand you push it in towards the center at the bottom and pull out at the top in order to slide these up and out so you can bait your trap. I'm also going to show you how to do that. The small version is 2¼ inches in width, and the larger version is 2¾ inches in width. Also put the metric scale down there for those of you who want that. Physical length of the little one is 6¾ inches, and the physical length of the larger one comes right to 8 inches. So it's much larger. So why not just get the bigger one? The triggers are just as sensitive. I'm going to show you the differences here in the bait container. This is for the small one. It has little round holes there. Some people I noticed complain that when you put your seeds in there, they fell right out and you couldn't really bait the trap. Notice on the larger one, these are slats instead of holes. The thing is plastic. So if you're going to trap a vole or a mouse, something in there, you want to get them out right away. You don't want to leave them in there to chew holes in the plastic and ultimately possibly escape. So there's the spring-loaded trigger plate there, and the larger spring, very easy to set. Just push it down and it goes. There's nothing else you need to do. But we do need to set up the bait. Now, I've washed these several times because I tested them thoroughly before I did a review. And I don't see any signs of rusting, although this looks like a zinc-coated spring. I don't think it is stainless. And if you notice here, the little trigger catch for that plate is just barely holding the edge there. And this is the small one, of course. Trigger's easy. Remember, our prey is about a half an ounce. And then the larger version has these little radiuses cut out, so supposedly that won't catch the tail. The other thing I like about that is the mouse is pretty far in by the time it triggers that, so its tail is well away from this door. Now when it flips shut, there is no latch that holds this door closed, it's just the spring tension. But I didn't notice the mice demonstrating any potential to pull that open and escape on their own. I'm using black oil sunflower seeds, and I'm using regular peanut butter, creamy peanut butter, not chunky. And I'm going to show you also how to cover the scent on your hands for those of you who are concerned about that. I haven't noticed a big difference, but I'm going to demonstrate a method, and that is to coat my fingertips with the peanut butter before I touch any of the traps. Now these traps are very inexpensive. I think I got a 6-pack of the small ones, and I got 2 2-packs of the large ones. I will put a link down in the video description below so you can check it out for yourself. And they come in these plastic bags just like this. We're going to pull this one out and we're going to smear some peanut butter on the outside of it. So we're going to handle this thing with butterfingers, literally. I'm going to pull off the end and I'm going to show you my magic trick, which is really very practical and simple. You want to make sure, by the way, in your bait holders that those openings face the interior of the trap, not the outside. Turn them both upside down here and then we're going to load them up. The keenest senses for these deer mice would be the sense of smell, sense of hearing. They also have huge eyes, so they see very well. House mice, a little different story there. But see, you load it up upside down. How easy is that? Turn the trap upside down. Slide your bait container onto it, then flip the thing right side up. Some people said that every time they went to flip it over, they couldn't keep the bait in and couldn't get it in the trap. Well, that's how you do it. And there's holes everywhere. And you've got these slats. I'm going to show you the next bait method here. Again, black oil sunflower seeds. All the mice in my area, rural United States, love to go after seeds. And black oil sunflower seeds lead them to feeders and things like that. But I'm also going to prime it with peanut butter. Now, peanut butter works great while it's fresh. The scent really gets into the air. But peanut butter dries out. Peanut oil kind of dries up. So the seeds actually will continue to send their smell out for a long time, but peanut butter needs to be refreshed. So if you're setting this up for a long period of time, seeds are better. And that's all there is to it. That trap is set. Just carry them around in a plastic bag and go set them wherever I need. And I'm going to put some, the two large ones are going in my basement on the wall because the width is perfect. Anything that's going in either direction has to go into one of these traps. Now the little one is back out here in my bee shed on the floor. There again is that big A24 trap on the right. But my reset small version of the capture trap is right here, and this is another mouse. Caught him. Check it out. Tail's not caught in the back either, but that mouse is not happy. But I also know you want to see this in slow motion. Goes all the way in there. You know, they would benefit by making these traps longer, because then they would be well in before they hit the treadle and trigger it. But this one did not get its tail caught, so that was good news. That doesn't mean it's happy to be in there, running around, throwing itself against that little spring-tensioned closing door. Now, if you leave them in there for a long time, remember, not only is it distressful to the animal, but they can actually chew through the plastic, so you want to check these every day. And as I've done here, I have a camera on it that's motion-activated, so I can check in on them. And you can put these all over the place, in your attic, in your basement, in your garage, wherever you might have a problem with mice moving in. Now here's the above view, and lower right there you can see that Arlo 2 Pro camera. Those things go anywhere. Totally wireless. You set it down there and it turns on. I have not seen any rats this year, thank goodness. But the mice, live catch traps, lots of fun. Totally up to you what you're going to do with the mouse after you get them. I highly recommend that you don't handle mice with your bare hands and you don't try to turn them into pets. Here's a little rascal, once again on the kitchen table. So we've got a couple of them now. And we're going to talk a little bit about the mice. So what's going on with these guys? They are found all over the United States. Deer mice, there are a couple of different subspecies of this mouse. But if you don't catch them, one of these mice can mate and have 72 offspring every single year. Now, yeah, I'm giving them water in this little petri dish, and yes, I'm letting them have black oil sunflower seeds. And by the way, I'd like to point out that these two mice were caught probably 150 feet away from each other. That does not mean they were not related. But when I put them both in this fish tank together, they were very leery of one another, but by the end of the morning, they were actually sitting next to each other and even started grooming each other. So they are very social. Normally, this is how they would get through winter. Not in my house, of course, but they would make their own little grass nest out there about six inches or so in diameter. They weave grass, they bundle it all together, they line it with fur, and then you might find when you open up a little nest like that, if you come across them, that there are several mice in there because they share body heat. They don't really go into hibernation, they go into a state of torpor, much like honeybees do. They just slow down their metabolism, they don't completely go into a hibernative state, they run out and they take advantage of warm days. What on earth can they eat? They eat everything. They eat seeds. They'll be in your bird feeders and things like that. So if you've got a bird feeder that drops seeds on the ground, they might zip out there at night. Huge eyes. Whenever you see large eyes like this on a mammal, that means it's nocturnal. That thing is going to have good vision in the dark, and these do. Again, they have a great sense of hearing, great sense of smell. They're going to find things. Now, in the past, I've tested live catch traps. I've been doing this for many years. And I used to live trap them, and then I took one way off, probably 150, 200 yards into the woods, turned it loose. That particular mouse had a notch on its left ear. And that same mouse showed up in the same exact trap within a day or two, no matter where I seemed to turn it loose. Turning mice loose is not always a solution because they're just going to find their way right back into your buildings, whatever path they took to begin with. And yes, I've done the stuffing of copper mesh, copper wire, stainless steel screen. We look for the openings, we close them up, and these little mice can go just about anywhere. Remember, they only weigh about half an ounce to an ounce. They're only about 6 to 8 inches long total, and about half that length is going to be the tail, so that includes their tail. And I've seen them going across fields at night. They are lightning fast. They show up on motion cameras, they jump on beehives, they climb bee stands. And it is amazing what they're capable of doing in extreme low light. The one that was in the basement could go straight up a concrete wall. So coming up with ways to trap them is always fun. It's up to you whether you try to turn them loose outside again. If you think you've satisfied sealing up the pipe opening or stuffing tube or wherever you think they're finding their way in, then you might be safe to turn them loose right in your own yard again. I'm not saying you can't. I'm just saying that their chances of coming right back in are very high. And you might want to consider donating them to a wildlife rescue group or something like that. And that's not because they want mice to rescue. It's because, and expect that they will do this, they need them to feed recovering raptors. They need them to feed recovering wildlife. So they're actually a prey animal. Everything out there eats mice. Birds of prey eat them, owls eat them, coyotes eat them, raccoons eat them, everything that comes across these mice. And here's what's interesting. The biomass that they provide in the environment is more than these large animals that eat them. That's how prolific they are. They are absolutely at the bottom of the food chain. They also eat insects, they eat slugs, they eat worms, they eat everything. That's why they're so good at surviving. So I hope you've enjoyed this video, and I hope that you'll look at some live catch traps if you want to have some fun and collect some mice unharmed. Maybe you've got kids at home this year that you want to show them what these animals look like, and I recommend that you put them in something like this 10-gallon glass fish tank so that you're separated from them. And contact somebody that's in raptor rehab or something like that and see if they want the mice. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.